Conservation of energy is one of the fundamental principles of physics. Simply stated, energy can be converted from one form to another, but is never destroyed. In this experiment, the conservation of energy principle will be tested as kinetic energy of a speeding bullet is converted into thermal energy. A 22 caliber rifle will be used to fire a bullet into a stationary piece of lead. Since energy is conserved, the kinetic energy of the bullet must be converted to some other form upon impact with the lead mass. By measuring the change in energy of both the bullet and the lead mass, the conservation of energy principle can be verified. The two key elements are the bullet and the lead mass. Traveling through the air, the bullet has an energy equal to its mass times the velocity squared divided by 2. The mass of the bullet is measured to be 2.6 grams, and its velocity can be determined using an electronic device known as a chronograph. The chronograph consists of two optical sensors mounted at a known distance from each other. As a bullet travels above the window of the optical sensors, the chronograph measures the amount of time required for the bullet to pass between the two points and calculates the corresponding velocity at an accuracy of plus or minus 5%. The lead mass has a tapered hole in which the bullet will be captured. With a measured mass of 83.9 grams, the increase in thermal energy will be determined by multiplying the mass times the specific heat times the overall change in temperature. The mass is placed into a fixture which is lined with cork. The fixture is then mounted in a stand which locates the mass at the exact height of the gun barrel. To determine the starting and finishing temperatures, a temperature probe is mounted into the rear of the fixture so that it is in contact with the lead mass. The starting temperature is recorded at 26 degrees Celsius. A bullet is loaded into the firing chamber of the rifle and the bolt is locked into place. After the rifle has been carefully aligned with the target, the bullet is fired. To prevent unwanted heat loss, a piece of insulation is placed over the opening in the fixture. After a short period of time, the temperature of the mass has stabilized, and a final temperature of 51.3 degrees Celsius is recorded. Given this data, the increase in thermal energy, delta Q, can be determined. By multiplying the combined mass of 86.5 grams times the C sub P value for lead of 0.128 joules per gram degree Celsius, times the difference in the final and starting temperatures, a net increase in thermal energy of 280 joules is calculated. To determine how well that compares with the original kinetic energy of the bullet, a measure of the bullet's velocity must be obtained from the chronograph. The digital readout indicates a bullet speed of 1,647 feet per second, which is equivalent to 502 meters per second. Using the equation for kinetic energy, an initial energy of 328 joules is calculated. A comparison of the change in thermal energy of the mass following impact to the measured kinetic energy of the bullet shows that over 85% of the initial kinetic energy has been converted to thermal energy during the experiment. That portion of the bullet's energy not resulting in a temperature increase can be attributed to both heat loss to the mass's surroundings and to work of deformation performed on the bullet during its impact.